Hello, dear students. In this chapter, we have studied different properties of parallelograms in the form of theorems. One more theorem also remaining there in the chapter. That one is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Yes, that is the eighth theorem. Theorem statement is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Yes, dear children, we know that in a parallelogram, two pairs of opposite sides are equal and parallel. But this theorem says that no need of two. If one pair is parallel and equal, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Okay. Then using that one, we can do one problem. ABCD is a parallelogram in which P and Q are midpoints of opposite sides ABCD. ABCD is a parallelogram in which P and Q are midpoints. Midpoints of the side AB and CD. If AQ intersects DP at S and BQ intersects CP at R, show that APCQ is a parallelogram, DPBQ is a parallelogram, PSQR is a parallelogram. Yes, we have to prove this APCQ, DPBQ, PSQR. These are parallelograms. Okay. It is given that ABCD is a parallelogram. We can start from there. Yes, it is given that ABCD is a parallelogram. We can name it A, B, C, D. And it is also given that P and Q are midpoints of AB and CD. P and Q are midpoints of AB and CD. So here ABCD is like change. AB, CD. Okay. And it is given that P is a midpoint of AB and Q is a midpoint of DC. P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of DC. And AQ intersects DP at S, AQ. So you have to join AQ and DP. AQ. AQ and DP. Yes, this is the given figure. S and R. Yes, this is the given figure. First, you have to prove that APCQ is a parallelogram. APCQ. Identify APCQ. Which one is APCQ? We have to prove APCQ is a parallelogram. How will you prove that one, dear children? Yes, here it is given that ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD parallelogram means you know that AB equal to CD. Is it? AB equal to CD. Yes, if AB equal to CD, then it is given that P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of DC. Okay. From this you know that AB equal to CD. If AB equal to CD, what we can write? Half of AB equal to half of CD. Half of AB equal to half of CD. Then what is half of AB? AP, P is the midpoint, means half of AB is AP. And same way, Q is the midpoint of DC, means half of DC is QC. So what we can write? Half of AB is AP, half of DC is QC, is it? So now we got AP equal to QC. We got AP equal to QC. That is, in the quadrilateral ABCQ, AP equal to QC, and also AP is parallel to QC. Why? Because we already have AB parallel to DC. If AB parallel to DC, means AP is the part of AB. So AP parallel to, yes, QC is the part of DC. So AP parallel to QC. Now we got AP parallel to QC and AP equal to QC. Then by using theorem H, in a quadrilateral APCQ, there are one pair of parallel sides, and that they are equal also. In a quadrilateral, if one pair of sides are parallel and equal, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So now we proved that APCQ is a parallelogram. Okay. Next, what we have to prove? Next we have to prove same way PBDQ is a parallelogram. PBDQ. Okay, identify PBDQ. PBDQ. We have to prove this PBDQ is a parallelogram. Same method, dear children. Here also, we can tell that AB equal to DC. Then, half of AB is PB. Half of AB is PB, is it? Then half of DC is DQ. So PB equal to, we got that PB equal to DQ. Same proof what we used to prove that APQC is a parallelogram. Here ABCD is a parallelogram. So P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of DC, means PB equal to DQ. Yes, if AB equal to DC, its half also will be equal. Now we got PB equal to DQ and also PB parallel to DQ. PB parallel to DQ means how? Because the sides AB and DC are parallel, so its parts also parallel. Now we got in the quadrilateral PBQD, PB parallel to QD and PB equal to QD. So by using theorem 8, yes, in the quadrilateral, one pair of sides are parallel and equal. So, PBQD is a parallelogram. Okay. Yes. Next, we have to prove that PSQR is a parallelogram. Which one? PSQR. We have to prove this PSQR is a parallelogram. Yes. Listen, dear children. Here we already proved that PBQD is a parallelogram. PBQD is a parallelogram. So PBQD parallelogram means what we can write here? PD parallel to Q. PD parallel to BQ. PD parallel to BQ. PD parallel to BQ means PS parallel to RQ. PD parallel to BQ means its PS is a part of PD and QR is a part of QB. So full S. This PD parallel to QR means its a part. These two sides. These are the parts of the PD, parts of PD and the QB respectively. So PS parallel to QR. Same way. Yes. Then we know is consider the parallelogram APCQ. In APCQ, APCQ is a parallelogram and AQ parallel to BC. APCQ parallelogram means AQ is parallel to PC. If AQ parallel to PC, then what we can tell? SQ parallel to PR. SQ also parallel to PR. Is it? Yes, this one. SQ parallel to PR. If yes, now we got in the quadrilateral PSQR two pairs of parallel sides. That is SP parallel to QR and SQ parallel to PR. So, what we can tell? PSQR is a parallelogram. Okay.